What's the future of Python on mobile platforms? Really interesting question that I got from a reader. In this video, I want to share some of my thoughts on this topic. So let's jump right in. I want to show you some projects that I think are relevant to this question. So number one is a framework called Kivy, and it is a cross-platform open source Python library for developing applications that also work on mobile devices, that work on all kinds of operating systems. And it's a very cool project. So the purpose of Kivy is to enable you to build graphical user interfaces that work on many different platforms using Python. Here on the website, you can see some examples of what people have built in terms of graphical user interfaces or little games and graphical applications using Kivy and Python. So Kivy gives you some standard controls and some graphical primitives or UI primitives that will look the same on any platform, and you can use it to build applications that work on mobile phones, desktop computers, and so on. That's kind of the big advantage of using Kivy. The biggest downside, in my opinion, is that these applications will not look very native. So there are some built-in UI elements that you can use, but they look the same. They look the same across all platforms, which is kind of a pro and a con at the same time. So with Kivy, you're getting different UI elements like buttons and text fields that look the same across many different platforms because they're all implemented custom or implemented specifically for Kivy. And that means your application is going to look the same on a mobile phone and on a desktop computer in terms of the way the UI looks. Now, this could be a good thing or a bad thing. Kind of the biggest downside here is that your application won't really look like the native like a native application would on the operating system. And you can see that used here to a great effect or to really positive effect in an application like Yiko, where it's like an external multi-touch controller for making music. And here the custom UI works really well. You know, you don't really expect this to look like the standard buttons on your desktop computer, but for some other applications, it might be kind of the opposite of what you want to do. So Kivy can be a great choice, but it has some upsides and downsides associated with it. It's going to be interesting to see how this develops in the future and you know, what new features are going to be introduced here. But it's certainly going to play a big role in the future of Python or in Python's future in the mobile development space. Now, another project that I'm really excited about is the Beeware project. And this is kind of a collection of different frameworks, tools, and libraries that you can use to implement native UIs across multiple platforms. So on the website, there's a good primer here where they tell you about what you can do with Beeware. And it took me a while to find this actually. But really, this is an abstraction layer you can use to write native iOS apps, native Android apps, and native desktop apps using Python. And it's kind of cool. So what the Beeware or parts of the Beeware project allow you to do is to write applications that look exactly like they should on a specific platform. So an iOS application written with PyBe or this Beeware project, it's going to use the native controls and it's going to look like a first-class application on that platform. And it's going to be the same with an Android application or a Windows application or a macOS application. Those applications built with the Beeware project, they're all going to have this native look and feel. And I'm really excited about that because I really believe that whatever application you build, it should take into account how the underlying platform works, the platform where you want this to run on. It should feel native to that platform. So the PyBe project, I think, is very, very exciting. It's kind of still in the early stages, but it is a very, very cool project, and I'm really excited about the future developments here. It's open source, you can contribute to it. It's the same with Kivy. So if you're interested in mobile development with Python and you want to make the future better there, now is the time to join these projects and to jump in and to do something great for the Python world. So in summary, I think the future for Python in the mobile space is looking brighter, let's say, because right now in my opinion, it's not very bright. I mean, if I were to write a mobile application today, my first choice would not be to do it in Python, to be honest. But this can change in the future. And I think especially with the adoption that we're seeing with Python at the moment, there's going to be a pretty good reason to go and see if we can enable people to write really great looking native-looking applications using Python. And projects like Kivy and Pybe or the Beeware project here, they're doing a great deal to make that future happen. All right, if you have a Python question that you would like me to tackle in a future video, then just leave a comment below and be sure to like and subscribe.